Hey everybody, how are you doing? I hope you're all doing well. And today I want to do something different than I do normally. And that is watching a YouTube video together with you guys. And I'm going to break into the video every time there is something said of which I think is audio technically incorrect. And let's close my laptop because that thing is making a lot of noise, which I don't want in my recording. I want better sound. Ish. And the video that I want to watch is the $1 million, the world's greatest audio systems and United Home Audio tape desks. This video is obviously not about studio engineering, but more about hi-fi and audiophile kind of stuff. For guys that don't know what an audiophile is, I call them an audio fool. Yes, this video is biased. Audiophiles are people that are spending a lot on snake oily stuff and you know, wizardry in order to get a better sound in their in their homes and in their setup. So let's watch this video and let's see what I think of it.
Okay, we're coming up to the entrance of United Home Audio.
Oh,
let's go in.
Welcome to United Home Audio, Peter.
Hi, Greg, how are you today?
Great, come on in.
Thank you.
Definitely not acted.
Here we go.
If you have bi-wire capable speakers, you can run 4 of the amps, 2 for each speaker. Mm-hmm. And you can also adjust the volume by remote control, but you can also adjust the bass volume.
Look at this. This is what always interests me. Look at behind this amplifier. There's the wall outlet, as we all have in our homes. This is an American one, I think. Yeah, the American one has a smiley. And you see those very thick cables. And I never understood why they are using those thick cables, because what is the benefit of having a better power cable when at the other side of the wall there's just normal copper? Or, well, that's what I'm thinking, because I don't know if they also had a cable from, you know, the other side of the wall to the energy reactor, you know what I mean.
Our visit and tour of United Home Audio's home theater area, and then we're gonna come over to the...
It's just a kitchen. What is also interesting is that it's a solid wall over here, solid wall over here, solid wall over here. There aren't any acoustics in the room. How can you check an audio system in a room that isn't acoustically optimized? That's also something that boggles my mind, and not only with this video, but with a lot of those audiophile things. I don't understand it.
Can we come into the main room?
Sure.
Here we go, viewers. This is what it's all about. This is the heart of United Home Audio's main listening studio.
Oh. The acoustics change over here, that's cool. So they have a few carpets on the wall. Still not, you know, acoustically optimized, but it's at least something.
And this apparatus here, a lot of people, when they look at it, they think that's a mid-range. This is actually a woofer. Plays down to 100.
That's a woofer. You can also, by the way, about the acoustics, you can hear it in his voice. You can hear how the room is not really acoustically optimized.
Three-dimensional image coming off of this because of the way it works. People think, well, it's radiating in 360 degrees, which is true, but also because of the curve of these radial Strahler drivers, it's also shooting like this.
Yeah. So now instead of having it directly to your ears, you will also hear the reflection from all the walls and all the ceiling and stuff, and that isn't processed. So what I would do is, you know, if I would have a speaker radiate directly to me and also to the wall and then to me, then I would delay the signal that would come directly to me so that it at least arrives in phase at my ears.
Down. So it's not only just doing 360, but it's filling in the information with a little bit more natural presentation. Mm-hmm. You know, if you look at a cello is not flat. a cello or a violin or an instrument's designed, you know, to bring out more of the music. And that's kind of what these do.
No, that's not what they do. Because they are radiating full range sound, the same sound, in 360 degrees. A cello doesn't, you know, if you walk around a cello, it sounds different from every single direction. And this one is radiating the same sound in every single direction.
Was the fact that this room that I have here, which is very secluded in the house and everything, it's not a perfect room.
Boom! Light bulb.
Okay. So the thought process was, if the room isn't perfect, what can I do to the room to make it more perfect? And Shunbuk had a plan for that. And this is what's called a spatial sextet, because I'm using six of these devices on the pole. And what they do is they take these Mingo discs that are tuned by Bill Ying, and it puts them in an array of three. Each one is oriented in a different configuration to work as he wants it to work. And you have one down below, you have one at a specific height, and then you have one way up here at 78 inches that is essentially making a sonic room boundary kind of
what?
And if you notice, there's one, two, three of them, and on the opposite side of the room, equidistant from the listening position, you have another one, two, three to define the space.
What did he just say? What? So, discs of wood are optimizing the acoustics? Dude! Does the sound system also include Harry Potter in it, or?
The room is not of perfect dimensions. You have a space over here. When I first came into the room, I realized when I walked in and I was talking to Greg, my voice sounded very contained within this listening space here, and kind of in defiance of the shape of the room.
That was the idea, yep. And I think, you know, when you sit down in the sweet spot and you listen, they, you know, because of the quality of the system and the quality of the source, of course, and everything else that makes a difference, you don't notice anything limiting the sound. It's like there's no walls, there's no ceiling, it's just sounds erupting out of 3D space. And the amps as well
looks
as
cool.
The preamp are all sitting on Shunbuk GDRs,
of
giant
course.
Diamond radiators.
Of course.
A little bit of a look here.
Of course.
There you go.
Again, those wooden
my
stuff.
My opinion adds a little dimensionality to everything.
Mm-hmm. CD.
Wait. Let's rewind.
Giant diamond radiators.
There's a little bit of a look for yours. There you go.
Which, in my humble opinion, adds a little dimensionality to everything.
Mm-hmm. CD player here.
CD player.
He is saying that the feet underneath his preamp is adding dimensionality to the sound. I'm going to put some feet under my console. Like, give me some piece of wood, I will have a more dimensional sound and I can sell it on my website and say to everybody that my studio is more dimensional than a different studio because my console sits on wooden feet with diamond pins underneath it. That sounds crazy, right? Maybe because it is.
Okay, and the deck next to it is playback only.
Playback only,
okay.
Yeah. A bunch of different features on some of these decks.
I don't really understand why they use tape as a playback source, and it's quarter inch tape as far as I can see. That's not the most dynamic, you know, use half inch or one inch stereo tape if you are going to do it.
This deck also has a super grounding device in it, which is a device specially made to scavenge noise out of the ground, and works very well in AB comparisons. Everyone prefers the grounding device. Is it necessary? Of course not. These are things to push the envelope.
Really interested in a schematic on how that super grounding would work, because you could also just use, well, I don't know, balanced audio?
So let's do that. Let's play something for the viewers. Let's play a little bit of something from an Opus 3 sampler tape. And viewers, if you're viewing this and you're curious about this one box, you...
I got an error in my brain there. Are they really... they are going to play something for the viewers? Why? And how? Let's see what happens. No. No! If this is how the system sounds, I wouldn't even spend a dollar on it. But why are they doing this? Are they... they are really doing this. That walkthrough was cool. Although there was a lot of snake oil in there, or bullshit, or wizardry, or Harry Pottery stuff. But this! Are they really filling a video? Like, more than 10 minutes with music played back through that sound system, and then received through a... almost mono microphone that isn't even full range, there isn't even lows in there. Why? There's nobody that's going to say, whoa, this will sound good. And it's going on and on and on. No, no way, no way. What I have to say about this whole audiophile stuff, this is not the only video. I mean, go on YouTube, search for this type of things, and you will end up laughing the whole evening until your balls are out of your pants. I mean, it's super funny. The funny thing about this is, well, I have heard multiple of those very expensive systems on different places. And I have to say, they do actually sound amazing. The stereo field is always amazing. There's like a real like virtual stage in front of you. But I also heard the same amazing sound on way cheaper and way simpler systems. Systems that made more sense to me. And they, you know, those systems also sounded amazing. And also had that stereo field and 3D-ish sound, or how do you want to call it. So I think it's just a system that only looks better and makes you believe that it sounds better with those wooden discs and stuff. But does it really? Or did they just spend a lot of money on bullshit? I think they did, but I leave it up to them. I mean, if they are happy to buy this, then there are also people that are happy to make it for them. I'm not being disturbed by it, but it's always interesting to see how far they go. And there are people that go even further. I even have seen special wooden stands to lay your cables on, so it isn't affected by earth radiation. And the wood was also a special type of wood. It doesn't make any sense. It really doesn't make any sense. Anyway, that's all I wanted to say for this video. I will put the full version of my full reactions of the full video on Patreon. So if you want to see that, check out Patreon over here. And also if you want to check out one of my other videos more about studio related stuff, you can check one over here. Subscribe below, leave a comment, like, and I'll see you guys again in the next video. Bye bye.